Now, please welcome Breakthrough Prize co-founder Anne Wojcicki and star of the film The Apprentice, it's Jeremy Strong.
Okay, that was amazing. Thank you, Sergey, Anna, and David. Life on Earth was sculpted by the slow hand of evolution. And evolution is a miniaturist. It works at the scale of genes and proteins, the nanomachines that run all cells. Ultimately, all the extraordinary abilities of living organisms emerge from the structure of proteins. And designing new proteins gives us powerful new abilities, from medicine to industry to protecting the environment.
But making something truly original is nearly impossible. It is often said good artists copy and great artists steal. And until now, making proteins has meant working with existing material, refining nature's designs to improve their performance, but not inventing entirely new ones from scratch.
But our next laureate has harnessed the power of science and computation to break nature's mold and design entirely novel proteins.
By doing so, he is transforming the biological realm into a new arena of human creativity.
To be human is to be a master of machines. With them, we broke free of our limits, made the whole planet our home, and soared beyond it. But there is another world of machines, a hidden world within us. Proteins, the intricate nanomachines that run our cells, our bodies, all life on Earth. David Baker uses the tools of our world to enter theirs and design the first synthetic proteins with completely novel structures.
I actually think we're in the midst of a protein design revolution. We're bringing biology and biological engineering out of the Stone Age.
Nanomachines that could one day heal our bodies, protect our planet, and lift our civilization to the next level.
For developing a technology that allowed the design of proteins never before in nature, including novel proteins that have the potential for therapeutic intervention in human disease.
The Breakthrough Prize in Life Sciences goes to David Baker.
To me, science means working with colleagues to push the boundaries of human knowledge. And it can take you places you never expected. The breakthroughs that have enabled this were made by the many brilliant students and postdocs I have worked with over the years. But the careers of young scientists in the United States are now at risk because of funding uncertainties. Universities are cutting graduate admissions, so you can't even start down the scientific path. And they're cutting faculty positions, so there's no ways of actually becoming an independent scientist. And we've heard tonight about the wonder and amazing things that science can do. So we must work together to restore these opportunities. Thank you.